Welcome back to the OpenVINO channel. Calibrating models to integer is probably the fastest way for you to accelerate the performance of your models. You can go and retrain your models with a more compact data format, but I guess that this is faster. First benefit is obvious. We can squeeze 4 int 8 into a 1 floating point 32. So model weights and memory bandwidth required are smaller. In addition, we're getting the acceleration of SIMD, single instruction, multiple data operations. For example, AVX2 can pack 32 and AVX512 can pack 64 int 8 into one data structure and perform the same operation on all of them in one clock cycle. So the performance gain is obvious, especially on a Xeon machine. And if you have a machine that supports Intel DL Boost, you can enjoy a significant additional acceleration to all your convolution layers. DL Boost is basically new instructions to accelerate the inner loops of convolutional neural networks. You can think about it as a fusion of few layers that can accelerate all your convolutions operations by up to 3x. In this video, video 68, I'll talk about the concept of the post-training optimization toolkit, which is part of OpenVINO. In video 69, next video, I'll demonstrate a full example of quantizing a model to int 8 stage by stage. I have to mention that the easiest way by far to operate the POT is using the DL workbench. Please watch our videos 42 and 43. But in this and the next video, I'll explain all the details and we'll operate the toolkit standalone. This is the overall flow for the POT, the post-training optimization toolkit. We start with a model that is already in IR, intermediate representation, in FP32 or FP16 format. And the target is to convert as many as permitted layers to int 8. As inputs, we will need the model IR files and the data set with the annotations. The POT is implementing a full inference flow. It has a reader that reads the data, annotation can be converted per need, the pre-processing stage can perform all kinds of manipulations on the data, then a launcher is called, basically inference engine. The inference could be done using OpenVINO, but also by the frameworks themselves, Caffe, MXNet, OpenCV, TensorFlow, etc. And the last stage is to calculate the metrics so we could check the accuracy. You usually do not have to worry about these internal stages, but if you have a special model, you can customize any of these stages. So if your data need a special annotation conversion or special pre-processing, you can build this specific stage yourself. The POT can work in two main modes. The first one is the default quantization. The target here is to perform the fastest possible quantization. It will execute relatively faster, and it is more performance focused. Despite the fact that it is not accuracy aware, in most cases, we saw that the accuracy drop is not that significant. This is a default quantization algorithm. You can read about the full algorithm and the stages and all the possible parameters you can play with in order to control this process. The second mode is called accuracy aware quantization. Here, the algorithm will usually quantize only some of the layers until the accuracy drops to the level you allow. It starts with running the default quantization, as in the previous mode, and then using an iterative process, each layer of the model is ranked based on the performance gain it can provide if converted to int 8 and the accuracy drop it can cause. At the end of the process, the optimal combination of floating point layers and quantized integer layers is set. And here, you can see the full documentation of the accuracy-aware quantization. You can read the full description of the flow and all the full possible parameters you can play with in order to control this process. Let's take a look and compare the neural networks before and after the quantization. On the left side, you can see the original model. You can see here all the layers one by one. On the right side, you can see the same neural network after quantization. And let's focus on the first convolution layer. You can see that two new layers were added before the convolution. These are what we call fake quantization layers. These are really directives to quantize, to int8, the two inputs to this convolution during runtime. So if you look at the XML file, you will not see them as int8 layers. They are really just operations done by the runtime during runtime. So the inputs to this convolution will be integer. The convolution will execute on integer. What about the output? That depends on the next operation. If the next operation requires FP format, the runtime will dequantize the output back to floating point. It all happens during runtime and pair the requirements of the next layer. And you can see many fake quantization layers all around. In the next video, we'll do together our full real example. Now, let's talk about the process. There are basically three major configuration files you have to edit in order to operate the flow. The first one is more of a global file that describes the dataset structure and location. You can define here multiple datasets. You have to know which dataset was used to train your model. And you can follow this link for the full instructions on how to prepare the dataset. You can see here, for example, that I'm using the ImageNet and I provide the location of the model, the annotation file, and so on. The second important configuration file is the model YAML file, and it defines the inference pipeline per launcher. For example, here, you can see that the framework, the launcher, is DLSDK, meaning OpenVINO, and you can see the details of the dataset, the pre-processing, and so on. The last one is a JSON file, and you can find it in this location. It describes the model that we are trying to optimize, and the algorithms to use. Here, we're using MobileNet V2 model and performing AccuracyAware Quantization on a subset of 3,000 images. The performance boost we see after calibrating models to int8 is huge, especially if you have a system that supports DL boost. In the next video, video 69, we'll do a step-by-step example. See you there. Thank you.